Hi guys, Ace here. Welcome back to The Matrix, where we're just stabbing vampires and kicking them in the groin.
And the camera randomly zooms.
Because screw Twilight. Ah, where are we? What's going on?
I don't know.
Oh.
We're in a theater.
Movie theater. What movie are they watching? Turn around, I want to see. Oh.
The one where a vampire comes to attack me. Ever seen that movie?
I will not let Twilight play on this screen!
Multiple vampires. Screw you.
Take this, Edward!
You did better as Batman anyway.
I'm gonna stab you right in your diamondy chest. What? That just a door just in the middle of... I can't tell if it's because of the Matrix or it's because this game is glitchy.
Yes. Show
yourself, coward. These guys are actually pale. They actually look like vampires. Yeah. Unlike the other guys who are just like beef heads, these guys actually look vampire-y.
Vampirific.
Vampirical.
Yes.
Actually, they look more like zombies.
Zombie vampires.
I guess.
Like that, the series finale of Deadliest Warrior. Zombies versus vampires.
Really?
They infected the vampires and it became vampire zombies. Because I guess the show knew it was ending, so it was like, fuck it.
I stopped watching that show after season 3, because I could tell they were starting to run out of ideas.
I mean, I really liked the show.
Again, yeah, the first 3 seasons, but then after that, I could tell they'd run out of ideas.
Where does it want me to go?
I don't know. Oh, there.
That's exactly where I just was.
Okay,
maybe not?
Oh, it's a live-action cutscene. Skip it.
Loading the dungeon. Oh my.
This is Mystery Dungeon. I'm not in the Matrix!
I can't tell where it went...
This way.
Oh, right, because the lower levels.
Yeah, because, like, castle.
This isn't Castlevania.
No, but it is a castle, sort of. I mean, it might as well be, Castlevania, just in the Matrix. The zombie vampires just. You just have infinite wooden stakes.
Yep.
Oh, this looks like there's gonna be like a boss fight in here or something. whoa. Looks like a coliseum.
Boss fight.
Yeah.
Cujo.
Mortal Kombat! I can't do the theme song. Oh, now we get music. It really does sound like freaking fight game music! What is this, Blade? This really does kind of look like the final fight scene in Blade.
Oh, and he summons minions. Great.
Leg sweep.
Blech.
I like this music, but though it's probably gonna get copyrighted. Just back kick. gonna punch in the air. Like, come at me. Come at me, bro. They just wait their turn. Very polite vampires. Waiting their turn. I love the poses he's doing. It's like, ooh, 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 ooh. Gotta watch your health bar, too.
I am. Oh, this is...
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Okay, I think you got him. Fatality!
And then kick it into his chest. He was still squirming.
What, are you gonna teabag him?
No, I'm waiting for my health to restore. But if you want me to.
I don't think you can teabag in this game. That's the best you're gonna get. There. Your legs glitching through his body. There.
Screw you, Cujo.
Now where are we going? This way?
That's where the arrow's pointing.
Yeah, it's stupid glitch. Oh, where? Why? Oh, I guess it. Right there. There we go.
Well, that was a boss fight for some reason.
Yeah.
Loading Cain and Abel.
Again?
No, I don't want to do something stupid like that.
Like what?
Like that escort one we had before?
Oh yeah, in the sewer.
Unless Cain and Abel are now vampires.
No, these vampires don't actually turn other... They don't turn red pills into vampires, they're just... They're just kind of perverted.
What is he doing to her?
I don't know.
I don't think we want to know. Don't worry, I'll kill you.
Well, when we said we didn't want that kind of a dungeon...
There's people trapped in there. Hands up, motherfuckers.
Yeah. Have some wood.
I don't know if they're vampires, necessarily. Hold them. Run. Run. No, hold them. Let me go.
Huh, so like the prisoners grabbed them, that's convenient. Are we Lilligant now?
No, we're not going to hide the body.
No, it just says put down the body. It's like, oh, for some reason we just had a grenade, I guess.
And we put her down to throw the grenade?
I guess.
We were still holding her before the cutscene.
I don't recall us picking up a grenade. When did we pick up a grenade?
I don't know. But is that powder that he used going to do something?
Oh, Keymaker. I could not foresee that our paths were not meant to cross yet. This key will free you from the labyrinth. Until we meet again. Until, I'm in the movie.
Until plot convenience.
Oh, these guys. The twins, ghost twins that, phase through stuff and they'll chase you in their car. And it's another one of you. We have to shoot at their car to keep them from catching us. And, also, and if this is a lot harder than the turn around, they're behind you. Just keep shooting infinite ammo. Just don't shoot your own car. Yay, music that's probably gonna get copyrighted. Basically, the objective of this is to not let them catch up to you. So, I don't think their car can be destroyed, but it can be slowed down. But you just have to not let them get too close to you. So keep the pressure on. This mission, I kept failing so much. In my original playthrough, I could not get past this because they are so persistent. You gotta keep the pressure on them. Make sure they can't get close. If they get close, you're done. Yeah.
Ooh. I'm just gonna shoot the wall. Unless they're in front of me.
I don't think they are. They're turn around. There they are. Yeah, you gotta make sure they can't. Oh, police this time. Those you can blow up.
Speaking of.
Yeah. Oh, finally. Wow, you actually did it. I don't know why I failed that so much.
It worked.
Eh?
Operator.
Is the exit clean?
As Vestal as my bungalow.
I'll see you soon.
Oh, live action cutscene. We have to skip it.
I think he said, as vested as my bunghole.
We have to skip it. It's a live-action cutscene. Those don't load in this ROM. Another live-action cutscene? No. Oh. Okay.
Training montage?
Nice view.
Gotta sexualize both races, both genders equally. Or, depending on how many genders you want there to be.
Oh, hi, Trinity.
You'd have the guts to come back here after the last ass-whipping I gave you.
That, dear brother, was an act of pure mercy, having beaten you now. How many times?
Oh, we're in the,
lost count when it hit double digits.
That, dear sister, was typical of the coddling members of my sex must bestow upon members of your sex to cajole them into playing.
You've done it again. You'll eat those words and half the rocks in this garden.
Come on, Trent. Make me.
We're in the construct, so this is a training simulation.
This looks like Comertage.
I mean, it's supposed to be based on Tibet, so. You can tell we're on easy because the actual Trinity would be kicking our ass.
Oh yeah.
If this was like actually, like, no joke, she, like, not just the character, the actress does her own martial arts. She even did her own martial arts in the Matrix 4 when she's like 50 years old. Most awkward training montage ever!
Just beat up your supposed sister.
No, they're not siblings. He has a crush on her, but she's already with Neo, so.
But he's literally referred to her as sister in this game, and she's referred to him as brother.
It's they're not actually brother and sister. It's they're more just friends. It's complicated.
That's what most women say. It's complicated.
And that is a gender stereotype. Well.
Damn, you are a good ghost.
You're not bad. Just a little distracting.
Yeah. I suppose so.
Just glitchy shadows.
You're sitting on the air. But I'm gonna go have sex with him.
Reminds us that belief is nothing to do with how or why. Belief is beyond reason. I believe because it is absurd.
You think it's crazy to believe it?
To believe what? That a single man can defeat an entire race of machines and end a war that has endured for over 100 years? Of course, it's complete lunacy, and that's why we must believe it will happen. Faith, by its very nature, must transcend logic.
Well, that's been an episode.
Yeah, I've been Ace. Keep it up your sleeve. We'll be right back. Bye.
Bye.